Have you been wondering whether you should use the Dubsado scheduler or a third-party scheduler like Acuity or Calendly? If so, I've made this video just for you. If you are new around here, hello, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Ray. I'm the creator of Productive Co. I help service-based business owners with their systems and automation. I'm also a certified Dubsado specialist. Now, in today's video, I'm going to help you determine the pros and cons of using a third-party scheduler like Acuity or Calendly instead of using the Dubsado scheduler. But before we dive in, I want to go over a couple of things. First, if this topic interests you, make sure you hit that like button down below so that I know to make more videos like this. You can also subscribe to this YouTube channel and hit the bell icon for notifications to get notified whenever new videos go live. Now, let's talk about a few disclaimers regarding this video. I'm going to cover a lot of ground today, but the first thing I want you to keep in mind is that this video is really created for people who are already using the Dubsado scheduler and feeling like it's not enough for them and wondering whether or not they should use Acuity or Calendly as a third-party scheduler. This video is really not for people who haven't tested out the Dubsado scheduler, and it's really not for people who are using it and finding that it works just fine for them. The second disclaimer I want to make is to consider when you were watching this video versus when it was recorded. Software is constantly making updates, and there might be new features released in between the time I recorded this video and when you watch it. The third disclaimer I want to make is in regards to pricing plans. Now, we're going to talk about some features that Acuity and Calendly have that the Dubsado scheduler does not have, but that does not mean that those features aren't necessarily available on the free plan or the lowest paid plan. You'll need to go back to Acuity and Calendly and verify which plan those features are on. The fourth disclaimer I want to make is that I'm going to be focusing more on what Dubsado does not have in this video rather than what it does have. The Dubsado scheduler has a lot of features that work well for a lot of small businesses. Again, this is going to be for those people who are finding that the Dubsado scheduler just doesn't feel like enough and are wondering if it's worth making the switch. Okay, so let's get started in the tutorial. Let's start by talking about the pros of using a third-party scheduler. Now, the first thing I would say is that Acuity and Calendly can allow you to book with multiple team members. At this point in time, with the Dubsado scheduler, you can only book with one team member. So if you have various members on your team that need to book appointments with your clients, a third-party scheduler is going to be a better fit. The second feature that is a pro of using Acuity or Calendly is recurring appointments. So if you have clients who need to set an appointment with you and have that same meeting every single week, you can do this with Acuity or Calendly. Now, there is a workaround with Dubsado if you want to do this. You actually just have the client book one appointment through Dubsado, and then you manually go to your Google Calendar and set up a recurring appointment there and invite the client to accept it. Now, if they want to reschedule the appointment, it could get a little bit more tricky than if they were just to go to Acuity or Calendly, but just keep in mind that that option is there. It does require you to take a manual step, but it's easy to do, and you'll only have to do it once per client. The third reason you might want to consider Acuity or Calendly is what I'm going to call, for the purpose of this video, a universal availability calendar. So when you go to Dubsado, you will create a variety of scheduling templates. So I'm in the templates tab here, and I have all of these different scheduling templates on the side. I have a scheduler for a 15-minute discovery call, and I have a separate scheduler for a 60-minute onboarding call. And what you will need to do for each of your templates is let Dubsado know what your availability is. So your discovery call, you might be available Monday, Wednesday, Friday for, whereas your onboarding calls, you're only available Tuesday and Thursday for. Now, here's where it gets a little bit tricky. When you go to have a client book an appointment with you, most of the time, they're going to book an appointment through a project. So let me just show you what this looks like. You can have a workflow automation send out the appointment scheduler for you. or you can send it manually. So either way, the appointment scheduler is going to end up in the project, okay? When the workflow sends it out, it will put it in the project. But if you were to send it manually, this is what it would look like. You'd go into the project, then go under appointments, and then you would add an existing scheduler template, or you could create a new one, a custom one from scratch. But we like to save time, so we always use templates here. So I'm going to use an existing template and then choose the template I want to send to them. Now I'm going to send it to them. This is where the problem occurs. So let's say that my availability changes. I have some big event coming up this week. You can go to your integrated calendar, like your Google Calendar, and block off that date, and it will sync to Dubsado's calendar. But let's say you want to change your availability forever. Like, you decided that you're only taking appointments now on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, and you're not ever going to take any appointments on Tuesday and Thursday. So you naturally go to the templates area and update your schedulers to remove those Tuesday and Thursday slots. However, when you make changes to the template area in Dubsado, it does not automatically update any templates that have been applied to a project. So that means the client who sees this scheduler will see the old availability. This is only going to be problematic for people who have yet to book an appointment with you after you change the scheduler. But this can get a bit annoying if you have all these schedulers sent out to clients and then you have to actually go into each project and update the scheduler. Now, I do know that Dubsado, the company, is aware that this is a problem and it is on their radar to fix. So once again, make sure that you double check that that update has or hasn't been released based on when you're watching this video. The fourth pro of using Acuity or Calendly is that you can reschedule directly from the appointment on your calendar. So for example, when your client books an appointment with you, they'll get an invite to add the appointment to their calendar. So I'm in a Google Calendar here, and I'm gonna show you an appointment I have booked with a coach. If I decide, you know what, something came up and I need to reschedule this appointment, I can go into my calendar here, click on the appointment, and then at the bottom, I have links to reschedule or cancel this appointment. At this point in time, Dubsado does not have this feature. The only way that a client could cancel or reschedule an appointment is through the confirmation emails or the reminder emails they receive for the appointment. Now, this is not to freak you out, because this is not going to be problematic most of the time. A client can just go to the search bar within their Gmail account or whatever email account they're using and reschedule from there. Or they'll just shoot you another email letting you know they need to reschedule. Now in Dubsado, if a client requests to reschedule or you need to reschedule with them, there is an area inside where you can actually do that and request to reschedule up here. So you can say reschedule appointment, or you could cancel the appointment here. Okay, so keep that in mind. Now, the fifth reason some people like to use Acuity or Calendly is honestly because of the appearance. Now, I think the Dubsado scheduler looks absolutely fine, but for some people, the way that things look is very important to them. And this just doesn't jive with the image that they want to portray online. They prefer how the Acuity or the Calendly scheduler looks. That's perfectly fine, but that is a common reason people choose to use these schedulers. Now, I think we're on number six, but the sixth reason you might want to consider a third-party scheduler is the ability to send text reminders. Now, I know that text reminders is something that Dubsado is actively working on. It's on their product roadmap, and it's something that's in like the planned phase, not like the idea phase, so it means it's moved further along. But at this point in time, you can't send text reminders to your client unless you're able to finagle something with Zapier, where you can connect a third-party tool to do that. With some of the Acuity and Calendly plans, you can include text messaging reminding. You usually have to pay for a higher plan to get those though. Now, the last reason you might want to consider Acuity or Calendly is if you have clients who need to book appointments with you, say every 30 days, these tools have a feature where you can send email follow-ups. So you can have remind them to book an appointment with you if 30 days have passed and they haven't booked their next appointment. This is generally going to be on a higher paid plan rather than a lower paid plan. But this is a nice feature to make sure that those clients who have, say, 10 sessions booked with you or paid for, to make sure that they use all of those sessions. Now, the Dubsado scheduler does allow you to put a cap on how many times a client can use the appointment scheduler. So you don't run the risk of your client booking more than the number of appointments they paid for. But if you want to have that reminder built in to let them know, hey, you haven't booked an appointment in a while, you're due to book your next one, here's the link, that might be a reason you consider Acuity or Calendly. However, there are some cons to using a third-party tool, so let's make sure we go over those as well. The first is the price. Acuity can get quite expensive depending on what plan you use. So it can go up to $45 a month, but it is a very robust tool. You know, this is obviously going to depend on what your business needs are, but that is something to consider. With Calendly, at the moment, you're looking at up to $16 per team member, depending on what your needs are. The second con is that you might experience some limit to the automation you can have. Now, I'm going to try to explain this as simply as possible, but it gets a little bit complex. So inside of Dubsado, you can create workflow automations, and that is where you have a series of different steps that happen. So you can say things like, when the Dubsado scheduler is filled out, I want this email to be sent and then this form to be sent once that email is set out. That's great. Dubsado is able to do that because it's all within Dubsado. So Dubsado can communicate, hey, when this thing is done, then this next thing needs to go out. When you use a third-party scheduler, it doesn't have the same level of communication with Dubsado. So it's more difficult to say, hey, when this Acuity scheduler is filled out, I want this to be done in Dubsado. Now, you can do this for some things, which I'm going to explain in a second, but you can't do this for everything. So it's really going to depend on what you want to use the third-party scheduler for. So Dubsado does not have a native integration with Acuity, Calendly, or any other scheduling tool. Dubsado has an integration with Zapier. Now, Zapier is a tool that acts as an integration tool for thousands of other softwares. It allows you to integrate one tool with pretty much any other tool. But there are limits on how you can integrate them. So the way that it works is all the companies that want to work with Zapier, they present some of their code to Zapier and they say, hey, we could set up automations for these things. And then the other company that you want to connect will say, hey, we can set up automations for these things. And you have to find something that matches. But remember, there's certain things that they can match. So this means that you can't necessarily get the scheduler to trigger all of the automations that you want it to inside of Dubsado. Now, if you want to take a look at what is available on Zapier, you can Google Zapier and Dubsado. It's usually the first page that comes up. Otherwise, you could go to zapier.com/apps/Dubsado. And this will show you what is available here. So I'm gonna scroll down actually quite a bit on the page. And then there's gonna be an area that says supported triggers and actions. A trigger is when something happens, an action is what actually happens. And so with every automation, you're gonna have a trigger and an action. You're gonna create a pairing. Now, the triggers listed here tells you when something happens in Dubsado, what do you want to happen outside of Dubsado? Okay, so it takes information from Dubsado and it sends it out to the third party. The action is when something happens in a third party, what information do you want to send over to Dubsado? Okay, so as it stands, the only action available is to create a new project in Dubsado. So the only Zapier integration that you could set up that starts in Acuity and then goes to Dubsado is to create a new project. okay? So you wouldn't be able to say, hey, after this client fills out this appointment scheduler, I want this contract to go out to them. You could only do that if you wanted it to create a new project and then had a workflow that sent the contract as soon as the project was created. So it is possible for some circumstances, but it depends on how you want to use it. I know that's kind of complicated. If it's too complicated for you, then consider sticking with the Dubsado scheduler. So those are the pros and the cons of using a third-party scheduler rather than the Dubsado scheduler. If you need more help with Dubsado, I have plenty of free resources available on my website, including a free Dubsado blueprint, which is linked down below this video. If there's any other questions you have about Dubsado, pop them in the comments below and I can make a video about them. All right, I'll see you next time. Bye now.